Welcome back to The Five. The American economy on the verge of falling back into recession. Frustration with politics as usual in D.C. is heating up. The right blaming wasted taxpayer money and a redistribution of wealth agenda emanating from the White House. And the left blaming the Tea Party for holding up the process.
I'm not afraid of the big bad wolf. I'm not afraid of anybody. This is a tough game. You can't be intimidated. You can't be frightened. As far as I'm concerned, the Tea Party can go straight to hell.
Oh, way to keep it classy, Congresswoman. Bob, the vitriol, the rhetoric has stepped up. What do you think of this?
Well, first of all, let me do some disclosure. I've said something close to that as well, but I would suggest to Maxine, who I've known for a long time, that all of us ought to step back here a little bit. I think suggesting somebody go to hell, or me saying that we want to beat the hell out of them, it's probably better if we just refer to them who they are. They're Tea Party people. Let's take them on and let's do battle at the polling booth. And the other thing, though, is you got to understand what goes behind here. For those of us on the left, the Tea Party does represent an attack on all the things we care about. You may not agree with them, and you obviously don't. But for us, they represent the worst of the worst. And so, but instead of us yelling at them like we do, and I take my own hit on this, let's go beat them, and we can beat them.
Can I want to defend her. She was actually inviting, when she said go to hell, she was inviting them to her district.
Oh my God.
I want to say something. She has every right. She has every right to be, you like that, Bob. She has every right to be threatened because the Tea Party represents something that wants to take away her power. She, if they are in hell, she is the protector of hell, the protector of entitlements that keep blacks in the underclass.
Okay, well, you know what? She's kind of known for this, you know, very bombastic rhetoric. And this is how she gets it going. She stirs the pot and she loves it. She's like, yeah, run me all day on Fox News. She likes to make these attacks. And by the way, she intimidates
everybody. I can relate to that.
I'm afraid to bring any ethics charges.
I want to go to you one second. But Bob, what is it about the Tea Party that has the left so up in arms, so fearful, scared that they have to resort to name calling, terrorists, go to hell?
I think, first of all, those of us on the left have overstated their influence, number one. We give them credit for bringing this ridiculous notion about deficit to the forefront when it doesn't matter. But we've lost that debate. We've lost the debate. But now they're trying to cut programs that to us are sacrosanct. And if they're going to cut those programs, that's war, and we'll go to war with them.
All right, Dana, what about the class warfare that seems to be, I don't know, emanating out of the White House? Is it only the White House, or is it the right to?
Well, incivil talk like that has always made me very uncomfortable. And I try to keep myself in check. I mean, imagine if somebody said that the Congressional Black Caucus could go straight to, you know, wherever.
I like that you don't say it.
I'm not going to say it.
But she's right. The double standard.
And I would never say it. And if I heard somebody in my own party say it, I'd call them out on it, too. And one of the things that President Obama has a problem with, I think, is that he, on paper, sometimes says that he wants to have more cooperation, less class warfare, less partisanship. And then they don't call people out for saying things like this. And what you have now is not just class warfare in between the classes, but inter-class warfare, which we wanted to get to because Kimberly,
you really do.
Billionaires versus billionaires. We had Warren Buffett last week in the New York Times, Harvey Golub today in the Koch brothers versus Buffett and Obama, questioning what is fair, what is your fair share, and if you're going to take more of our money, then could you spend it wisely?
We have Harvey's quote. Can we put that up in the full screen? Let's read it very quick. Before you ask me for more tax money from me and others, raise the $2.2 trillion you already collect each year more fairly and spend it more wisely, then you'll need less of my money.
Doesn't that sound like Harvey. It makes perfect sense? Bob, really?
Wrong.
It makes perfect sense. Why would you reward a government that is spending just carelessly, waste all abound, more regulations, more government entities that we don't need, and then reward it by saying, here's an empty checkbook with everything in it, just keep writing checks.
You think Harvey supported the war in Iraq? I think he did, didn't he? And these people, these rich people who supported the war in Iraq, do you think they take one dime of their tax dollars? We've never had a war. We haven't had a surcharge for doing that war, except for Iraq. And you think these guys are willing to pay for that? They've been rewarded over and over again. Buffett was right.
We should wage war.
They've been the most friendly Congress and the most friendly presidency.
We should wage war on irresponsible government.
Multi-billionaires saying rich people should be taxed more.
Sure.
But as it is, Bob, 47% of American households, we know the number over and over, don't pay a dime.
Why aren't you willing to pay for the wars?
Hold on. How about the top 1% paying almost 40% of all tax revenue? I mean, how much more can you do? How much more
because
can you tax
wealthy people? Because they make 52% of the money.
I think that they would be willing to have tax reform.
Hey, Dana, did you hear what he said?
Because they what?
I
they make more than half the money.
That is the most. What is that? What does that have to do with the tax rate that wealthy people pay?
The rate ought to be higher than that.
No, it has nothing to do.
Even if you tax them at 90%, you wouldn't get to
Eric's
touching
losing.
Our problems.
No,
the problem with what Buffett said is what his it doesn't have any effect on his life. You can raise taxes as much as you want because he's that rich. So he should be he should suffer from the taxes, which he never he doesn't have. It won't happen. So it's hypocritical of him to say that.
So half the country shouldn't pay a dime, and that's fair.
If we reform tax reform, they ought to broaden the base up. More should pay, right. But the wealthy should pay right. More.
There you go. There you have it coming up. Football or foot brawl. Disturbing video of a brawl in the stands and the violence that followed in the parking lot. The five of us will discuss what this says about our society next. There's got to be something.